There are a number of interesting phenomena in the nature which present us with a curious problem concerning energy. There has been a recent discovery of things called quasars, which are enormously far away, and they radiate so much energy in the form of the light and the radio waves that the question is, where does it come from? If the conservation of energy is right, the condition of this quasar after it has radiated this enormous amount of the energy must be different from its condition before. Yes. The question is it coming from the gravitational energy? Is the things collapsed gravitationally in a different condition gravitationally? Or is this big emission coming from nuclear energy? Nobody knows. You might propose that perhaps the law of conservation of energy is not right. Well, when a thing is investigated as incompletely as a quasar, the quasars are so distant that astronomers cannot see them too easily. Then, if such a thing seems to conflict with the fundamental laws, it very rarely is that the fundamental laws are wrong. It usually is just that the details are unknown. Another interesting example of the use of the law of conservation of energy is in the reaction when a neutron disintegrates into the proton, an electron, and antineutrino. It was first thought that a neutron turns into the proton plus an electron. But the energy of all particles could be measured, and a proton and an electron together did not add up to the neutron. Wow! Two possibilities existed. It might have been that the law of energy conservation was not right. In fact, it was proposed by Bohr. For a while, that perhaps the conservation law worked only statistically on the average. But it turns out now that our other possibility is the correct one. That the fact that the energy does not check out is because there is something else coming out. Something which we now call an antineutrino. The antineutrino which comes out takes up energy. You might say that the only reason for the antineutrino is to take the conservation of the energy right. But it makes a lot of other things right. Wow. Like the conservation of momentum and other conservation laws, and very recently it has been directly demonstrated that such neutrino do indeed exist. Wow! This example illustrates a point. How is it possible that we can extend our laws into regions we are not sure about? Why are we so confident that because we have checked the energy conservation here, when we get a new phenomenon we can say it has to satisfy the law of conservation of energy? Yes. Every once in a while you read in the paper that physicists have discovered that one of their favorite laws is wrong. Yes. Is it then a mistake to say that a law is true in a region where you have not yet looked? If you will never say that the law is true in a region where you have not already looked, you do not know anything. If the only laws that you find are those which you have just finished observing, then you can never make any predictions. Yet, the only utility of science is to go on and to try to make guesses. So, what we always do is to stick our necks out. And in the case of the energy, the most likely thing is that it is conserved in other places. Yes. Thank you, Richard Feynman. Of course, this means that science is uncertain. The moment that you make a proposition about the region of the experience that you have not directly seen, then you must be uncertain. But we always must make statements, yes, about the region that we have not seen, or the whole business is no use. That means you have to always make a statement, right? So that other people can investigate, follow, check it out, and keep going the experiment to uncover the truth, right? For instance, the mass of an object changes when it moves because of the conservation of energy.
Really? Really?
For instance, the mass of an object changes when it moves because of the conservation of energy. Because of the relation of the mass and the energy associated with the motion appears as an extra mass.
Yes, yes, yes.
So things get heavier when they move. Newton believed that this was not the case and that the masses stayed constant. When it was discovered that the Newtonian idea was false, everyone kept saying what terrible thing it was that physicists have found out that they were wrong. Why did they think they were right? The effect is very small and only shows when you get near to the speed of light.
Yes, 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 yes.
If you spin a top, it weighs the same as if you do not spin it, to within a very, very fine fraction. Should they then have said, if you do not move any faster than so and so, that the mass does not change? That would then be a certain. No. Because if the experiment happened to have been done only with top of the wood, copper and steel, they would have had to say tops made out of the copper, wood and steel, when not moving any faster than so and so. You see, we do not know all the conditions that we need for an experiment. It is not known whether the radioactive top would have a mass that is conserved. So we have to make our guesses in order to give any utilities at all science. In order to avoid simply describing experiments that have been done, we have to propose laws beyond their observed range. There is nothing wrong with that, despite the fact that it makes the science uncertain. If you thought before that the science was certain, well, that is just an error on your part. To return then to our list of the conservation laws, we can add energy. It is conserved perfectly as far as we know. It does not come in units. Now the question is it the source of the field? The answer is yes. The answer is yes, yes, it is the source of the field. Wow, this is what I really, really, really keen for knowing. Because this the source of field answer everything, like a gravitational force and electrical magnetic force. So it's source of everything, right? Everything. Einstein understood gravitation as being generated by energy. Energy and mass are equivalent, and so Newton's interpretation that the mass is what produces gravity has been modified to the statement that energy produces gravity. Yes, energy produces the gravity. There are other laws similar to the conservation of the energy in the sense that they are numbers. One of them is momentum, of course, mv. If you take all the masses of an object, multiply them by their velocities, and add them all together, the sum is the momentum of the particles, and then total amount of the momentum is conserved. Of course, energy and momentum are now understood to be very closely related. Because energy, the unit of energy is joule, is a kg times meter square per second square, right? And the momentum is mv, so mass times velocity means kg times meter per square, meter per second. So the only difference between them is either the velocity being velocity or velocity square, right?
Yes.
Energy and momentum are now understood to be very closely related, so I have put them in the same column of our table.
Yes.
Another example of the conserved quantity is angular momentum.
Of course.
An item which we discussed before, the angular momentum is an area generated per second by object moving about. For example, we have a moving object, and we take any center whatsoever, then the speed at which the area.
Sure.
At which the area swept out by the line from the center to object. Yes, object increases multiplied by the mass of the object and added together for all the object is called the angular momentum. Yes, so let me repeat it again. So for example, if we have a moving object and we take any center whatsoever,then the speed at which the area swept out by the line from the center to object increases, multiplied by the mass of the object and added together for all the object is called the angular momentum, and that quantity does not change. So we have a conservation of angular momentum. Incidentally, at first sight, if you know too much physics, you might think that the angular momentum is not conserved, like the energy did.Like energy, it appears in different forms. Although the most people think it only appears in motion, it does appear in other forms. In other forms, as I will illustrate. If you have a wire and move a magnet up into it, increasing the magnetic field through the flux, through the wire, there will be an electric current. That is how electric generator works. Yes. Imagine that instead of a wire, I have a disc. Instead of a wire, I have a disc on which there are electric charges analogous to the electrons in the wire. Yes. Now I bring a magnet dead center. I bring the magnet dead center along the axis from far away, very rapidly up to the disc, so that now there is a flux change. Yes. Then, just as in the wire, the charges will start to go around, and if the disc were on the wheel, it would be spinning by time I had brought the magnet up. That does not look like the conservation of angular momentum, because when the magnet is away from the disc, nothing is turning, and when they are close together, it is spinning. We have got a turning for nothing, and that is against the rules. Oh yes, you say. I know there must be some other kind of interaction that makes a magnet spin the opposite way. That is not the case. There is no electrical forces on the magnet tending to twist it the opposite way. The explanation is that angular momentum appears in two forms. One of them is angular momentum of motion, and the other is angular momentum in electric and magnetic fields. Wow! There is angular momentum in the field around the magnet, although it does not appear as a motion, and this has the opposite sign to the spin.
Sure.
If we take the opposite case, it is even clearer. Yes. If we have just a particle and a magnet close together, and if everything is standing still, I say there is an angular momentum in the field, a hidden form of angular momentum which does not appear as actual rotation. When you pull the magnet down and take the instrument apart, then all the fields separate, and angular momentum now has to appear, and the disc will start to spin.
Wow.
The law that makes it spin is a law of induction of electricity. Yes.